Hi guys, we're going to talk about the Action Center in Windows 10. Okay, the Action Center is a great addition to the Windows operating system, as it not only brings a history of your unseen notifications, like recent updates and the Windows Defender, but it also places shortcuts down here to your most used settings in Windows 10. And if you right click on the notifications, you can change the settings such as priority, how many notifications are visible, whether they're going to play a sound when they occur, and so on. So let's go through these one at a time. I've not got all of them visible because I've not got everything installed on this machine, such as Bluetooth, wireless. Let's start with the tablet mode. As you guessed, this toggles the screen into tablet mode. It makes the start menu easier to use on touchscreen devices. If we switch to tablet mode, eventually it'll come back. It's now split the start menu into just two views. And if you want to see installed applications, change the view to installed apps. But let's change that back now. Okay, the network. This will display available Wi-Fi networks, airplane mode, and also the wired connections. As a home user, it's unlikely that you will need to know much about this section, so I'll cover this in more detail in a later video when we get to networks. But what is useful is if you click data usage and then click usage details, you can see which is eating up the bandwidth on your internet connection. Note, this is just a shortcut to Microsoft's OneNote. If you're unfamiliar with OneNote, it's basically a component from the Microsoft Office suite for keeping all your project notes together. For those who are interested, I'll put a link below. All settings takes you to the control panel. There's a lot in here, so I think it would be better to go through each item as we use them. Location services, I can't turn it on and off on this machine because this is a virtual machine. You'd be able to toggle this if it was on your laptop. The shortcut to get into Windows control panel is Windows and I. If we wanted to get into enable location services and select privacy, click location, and here you can enable it, disable it, and if you scroll down you can see which applications are actually using it and turn them on and off, same as the mobile phone. Let's come out of there. Quiet hours. This one's still in development, I believe. The quiet hours setting allows you to not be disturbed with notifications, and at the moment it's only between 12 a.m. and 6 a.m. At the time of this recording, Windows 10 didn't have the facility to change these times, but I'm sure that will come with updates if you haven't already got it enabled. VPN. If you have any setup, this would be a list of the VPN connections. I've not used it, but I've not heard great things about this either, so let's wait and see. The next one is project. The project quick action is to project the display to another device, such as a second screen or a projector. Very similar to the project quick action that we just did, the connect quick action allows you to connect to display devices without any wires. Basically, it can be described as HDMI over Wi-Fi. To customize which quick actions are visible, go to All Settings or Windows I. And go into System and Notifications and Actions. Here you can add and remove what's available to your system. I don't use VPN. I don't have OneNote installed on this machine. And I don't like the tablet mode on this machine. Locations is not a point having that. And turn the connect off and the project off. That's more or less it. Incidentally, the other quick actions that aren't visible because I don't have them on my machine, they include brightness, flight mode, Bluetooth, battery. The reason these aren't available is because I don't have the hardware installed on this virtual machine. These would be more focused on laptops or tablets. I hope this has been informative for you, and I'd like to thank you for viewing. If you like this production, please click the like button, and if you find this channel useful, please subscribe. Any questions, comments, or suggestions for future videos, please add a comment and I shall endeavour to reply as soon as possible.